Hello, this is Gene.
Hey Gene, it's Dr. Jackson here.
Hey Dr. Jackson.
I have a patient who needs a fairly complex orthognathic surgery involving a maxillary advancement, mandibular advancement, and genioplasty. I have heard talks about splintless orthognathic surgery. Can DePuy Synthes provide options for this?
Yes, we can. There's a few options. My suggestion would be to use our titanium 3D printed guides and plates for maxillary advancement as well as the genioplasty. And then for the BSSO though, I'd recommend probably our traditional fixation.
That sounds good. Do you mind walking me through how exactly this procedure would work?
Sure. First, we would conduct a surgical plan to plan out all the osteotomies as well as the outcome. So during the surgery, what you'll do first is you actually take the maxillary cutting guide, place it on the maxilla, and drill each of the pre-index holes. You'll then make an osteotomy cut through the maxilla, which we will guide in the plate, which you typically do. Once you remove that actual cutting guide, you'll then line the plate up and actually attach all of the screws with the indexing holes. That gives you your actual advancement. So technically, you may not need an intermediate splint. However, some surgeons have been asking for it for precautionary reasons. Once you do that, you'll then move to your mandible. I know you typically like to use the trocar and percutaneous screws or your actual monocortical plate. Whatever you decide, we'll just do that the traditional route. And then finally, you'll do the genioplasty, which will be very similar to the maxillary printed plates and guides, where you index the holes, make your cut, and line the plate up.
That sounds good. How does the process work?
Good question. So we can do two different types of scans we can pick up. The first one is a CT cone beam, which will be 0.4 millimeter slices or less, or we can do a regular CT scan of 1.0 millimeter slices or less. As we've done with every orthognathic surgery, we'll need either dental models, or I know sometimes you like your intraoral dental scanner. Both will work. Once you do have them, I can pick them up. I know sometimes we have some issues with radiology, so I'm happy to drop off the CT scan protocol to them as well to make things go smoother. Once everything's dropped off and uploaded, what our team will do with Materialize, they'll confirm that the DICOM images are correct. And if they say everything's good to go, an engineer will then send you an email and ask what time and date works to plan the actual case. Once we do plan everything out, as I mentioned earlier, we'll mark out the cuts, the osteotomies, what the plate may look like, and any questions that you may have. Once we leave that planning session, in a day or two, you'll get a draft plan laying everything out as well as the movements. And if you think that occlusion looks good and you feel comfortable with the plates, we'll move forward with production and get everything ready to go.
Perfect. The patient already had a cone beam CT and intraoral scans. Can we do the planning session Tuesday at 4 p.m.?
Tuesday 4 p.m. works great for me. I'll confirm with our engineer and I'll keep you posted no matter what.
Sounds good. Thank you, Gene.
Thanks. Have a good day. All right, bye.
Okay, Dr. Jackson, let me show you the lateral view. How does that look?
I think we need to advance 2 more millimeters and decrease the occlusal plane by 2 degrees.
Okay. So let me come forward 2 more millimeters. I'll put my rotation point at midline and drop that occlusal plane 2 degrees. Okay, how does that look now?
Perfect.
Okay, great. If you're happy with that, then I will get a final report out to you within the next couple days.
Sounds good. Thank you.
Thanks. Have a great day.
You too.